Hey guys, welcome back on my YouTube channel Swift Series. And guys, today I'm gonna show you how you can implement certificate pinning and also public key pinning. Okay guys, in the last video we have seen what is SSL and what is the benefit of SSL and where the SSL will maybe failed. Okay, and so there is another option or more advanced layer of security, that is SSL pinning. Okay guys, so guys, in this video I'm gonna show you how you can implement certificate pinning and also public key pinning. Okay guys, so the SSL pinning can be implemented into two ways: certificate pinnings and public key pinning. Okay, so what is the differences between both them? I will discuss later, right? So let's get start with a demo project. So guys, this is my demo project, and there is a view controller basically, and there is no any UI. I'm not going to use any UI because I want to show you only how you can implement the certificate pinning. Okay, so this is basic a view controller. Okay, now guys, for doing the certificate pinning or public key pinning, you need the certificate of the host, right? Which host, from which you want to make the connectivity of your application. Okay, so suppose I want to connect my application or my application API with the Google API or the from the Google server. Okay, so for that purpose I need to open that Google server. Okay, and I need to download the certificate of that Google server. Okay, so let me go on my Firefox, and I can open, like I want to open the google.co.uk for my app. Okay, so I need the certificate of this host. Are you getting my point, what I'm trying to say? So how we can get the certificate? You can see a command on your screen. This is the command by which you can download the certificate of any host, right? So guys, okay, let's move on once again in our project. So guys, this is our project. This is main storyboard. I am not going through any UI design. Okay, this is my simple view controller. And guys, I have already installed LMOFire. Okay, so let me first of all remove this import LMOFire because this is no need. There is no need of this line. Okay, so I have installed the LMOFire. So I am going to show you how you can implement the certificate pinning or public key pinning using LMOFire. Okay, so guys, there is one file I have created, that is network manager, which gonna manage all the requests, right? I'm not going on the standard way of creating the network manager of like single creating the singleton class and whatever, right? The main focus is how to understand how to implement certificate pinning or public key pinning. Okay guys, so guys, this is my network manager, and okay, now first of all let me discuss the what is the difference between certificate pinning and public key pinning. Okay guys, so if you do the certificate pinning, then there is a problem actually. If you do the certificate pinning, then there may be a chance ki after 1 year or 2 year your certificate is gonna renewed, or your certificate is gonna, you know what, expired. Okay, how can you see the details of a certificate? Let's go on your Mozilla Firefox browser and open your host and just click on the this I button. Click on this arrow and go on more information and click on the view certificate. So guys, as you can see, this is the certificate of this host. Okay, and as you can see, it begins on this and it's gonna expire on this. Okay guys, so basically if your certificate is going to be expired, then you will have to update all the clients app. Are you getting my point? If you have used any certificate on your app, then in that case your app should be updated after the certificate expiration, and you will have to include that particular new certificate in your app, and after that you will have to send the update on the users. Okay, your app users. So guys, this is the problem of certification pinning. Okay, so to replace this thing, there is one thing comes in the picture, that is public key pinning. Okay, so if you do the public key pinning, then in future if your certificate is going to be expired or if your certificate is going to be renewed, then this thing can be done on the basis of public key. Means the public key will be same, only your certificate is going to be renewed, right? So this is the thing you should remember. Okay, so what is the difference between certificate pinning and your public key pinning? So better to take the public key pinning always in your applications. Okay, so now guys, let me come on the code once again. So this is the code which I am going to explore with you. Okay, so guys, first of all, let me discuss this function, and after that I will move on the another two functions. Okay, this is the core function in which I am getting all the certificates. So guys, first of all, I need to download the certificate, right, from the command line. So guys, let me download the certificate for Google. Okay, so guys, I want to download for google.uk, and same I will do here also. So guys, as you can see, my certificate has been downloaded into my home folder up into our project. Okay, so there is already one certificate. Let me delete it, and guys, just drag and drop the certificate here. So while you are dragging and dropping your certificate, make sure it is checked. This checkbox should be checked, SSL pinning demo, right? So that key, this certificate is going to be added in your bundle. Okay, so let me check, and after check guys, make sure this is added into your copy bundle resources within bundle phases. Okay, so this is our certificate which has been imported. Now let's go once again on your network manager. So guys, what I'm doing here, actually I'm loading my certificate from the bundle resource, right? So I'm getting the URL basically here, and after getting the URL, I'm going to create it as a CF data, and I'm creating a certificate, right, security certificate. As you can see, this is a predefined class, and I'm creating a security certificate with this data. So guys, I have extracted my certificate here, and I'm going to return the array of certificate. Are you getting my point? So this is the way of getting all the certificate in your code. Okay, after that guys, there are two functions. First one is pinning with public key. Another one is test pinning. Basically this test pinning is going to show how you can implement certificate pinning. Okay, so for certificate pinning guys, I am getting my certificates, all the certificates here from that function, and I am going to create an array for the server trust policies, right? So in which I have an array of dictionary, I have a dictionary, right? And within this dictionary, I'm going to take the hostname as the key and the server trust policy. So within the server trust policy, there is a enum, and I'm going to use the pin certificates enum, right? And within the pin certificates enum, you will have to pass all the certificates, right? And this key is going to tell whether the certificate chain is required or not, and to validate the host, right? So if you created your server trust policies, just you need to pass within your session manager. Okay, so I'm going to pass this within this session manager. Okay, so within the session manager, you need the session trust policy manager object, and within this session trust policy manager, you are going to pass all the server trust policies which you have created here. Are you getting my point? So this is the thing which you will have to implement for certificate pinning. So after creating this all things, you just need to request your host now, right guys? So let's test it first of all, and then we will move on the pinning. Okay, so we will move on the pinning with public key. So within this function, what I'm going to do, I'm going to do the same code which I have done for certificate pinning. Just all I need to do here is what, instead of here calling the pin certificates enum like we have called here, we are not going to call the pin certificates here. We are going to use the pin public keys, right? And instead of passing all the certificates, you just need to call the public keys function of server trust policy. So it's automatically going to get all the public keys from all certificates which you have included into your project. right? So if you have this certificate, then the public key of this certificate is going to be used here for this host. Means if you are okay guys, so this is the difference only within the public key and the certificate pinning. So guys, let's run and check whether is it working or not. Okay, so I'm going to access the http://google.co.uk from my view controller. So as you can see, I'm going to use this class, and I'm going to access this variable, and by which I'm going to calling this function pinning with public key. So instead of calling this function first, let me test with certificate pinning. Okay, so this is the function which I'm going to. So guys, as you can see in the terminal, we can see we are getting success and optional 200 status. Okay, so let me go into test pinning. So as you can see in the response, we are printing the status code and also the success. Clear my point guys? So if error is nil. Okay, so guys, the thing is what, how we can identify whether the certification pinning is implemented or not. So guys, for that let me make it as failure. For that, I'm not getting the certificates here, I'm commenting it, and I'm passing the blank array. In that case, what will be happen? There is no certificate for this host, okay, but we are getting the certificate from the server, so it won't be matched with the server certificate. Are you getting my point? In that case, this request is gonna fail. Okay, so let me run once again and test. So guys, as you can see, the request has been failed. Okay, so let me do the same once again. Okay, so this is the thing for certificate pinning, and the same thing applied for the public keys also, right? Okay, so let me run with public key once again. Okay, so let me comment this line and uncomment this line. So guys, you can get this project from the GitHub also. I will drop the link in the video description, so please check that link and you can download it. Okay, so guys, as you can see, once again the response is this. Okay, so guys, suppose maybe your question will be, suppose we have print the certificate for google.co.uk, but if I'm going to request the facebook.com, then it will be opened or not, and the request will be completed or not? Yes, of course the request will be completed successfully, because you are pinning the certificate for only google host name, okay, not for Facebook, right? So it will not give the impact on other hosts, right, if you are pinning for the Google. Clear my point, what I'm trying to say? So guys, this is the demonstration of certificate pinning and public key pinning. Okay, I hope you are able to understand what I'm trying to say and what we have done within this demonstration. Okay guys, so this is for this video. And guys, I want to tell one more thing. If you are doing the certificate pinning, then it is going to match the your stored certificate with the server host certificate, and it will compare by byte by byte data, okay, in the case of certificate pinning. But in the case of public key pinning, it is just going to match the public key of the your host certificate and your local certificate. Okay, so it will compare only the public keys, right? Where in the certificate pinning, it is going to compare all the data, whole data, right? So instead of going through certificate pinning, I recommend it to go through the public key pinning. Okay, so this is for this video guys. So if I was able to tell you certificate pinning and public key pinning, then kindly hit the like button for my video, subscribe my channel for the latest videos, and comment down if you have any problem related to this code. If you are not able to do the certificate pinning or you know what, public key pinning. So I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching this video. Bye bye, take care, have a good day.